if you look at the Arab Spring, Occupy Wall Street, all these horizontal movements, there was an idea that only horizontality would save us, like direct democracy, we will have general assemblies, speak for hours, decide together, and so on. Then you had, after 2011, I would say, this rise of radical left political parties, like Podemos in Spain, Syriza in Greece, and so on, where there was a belief that you need to form a political party in order to come to power. But what I think, if we are faced with these multi-layered complex problems of today, we also need to have a complex response. So my answer wouldn't be join a political party, just do a movement which will not join a political party, just do academic work or this or that. My answer is precisely what we are doing here tonight. I'm not saying this Elevate, God bless Elevate if it would stop climate change. I'm not saying Elevate is the answer, but at Elevate, what do you have in Elevate? You have an activist here who was before here from Nigeria, who is not building a wall, but who is growing plants in Africa. You have Pamela Anderson on the stage, which is quite unexpected, or it was unexpected a few years ago. You have Daniel, the organizing of Elevate. You have a random guy from Croatia who went to shopping to Graz because that was the only place that I could find H&M and such stuff. And you have music, you have discussions, mm-hmm. and in the end you have songs, you have fun, and so on. And I think what we are really missing is more fun. Right. I was at the children's protest in Cologne 2 weeks ago. It was really fun to jump, to sing, and so on. And I'm not going into this hippie bullshit now, we just need to sing and to fuck and whatever, and everything will be okay. No, but I'm just saying we need all this aspects, you know? I don't want to belong to a political party which doesn't know to dance. I don't want to belong to a movement which thinks that if you join a political party, you're already corrupted and you have to be killed. No, I think today we have to use everything we can. We have to use... We have to use musical festivals. In my country, where I come from, the right wing, fascist, if you want to say so, they're occupying institutions already. You have seen what's happening in Hungary. You know, there is no independent media anymore. The constitution was changed. Universities are being kicked out. If you look at any country, you will see this. Even if you go to the West, you will see there is a sort of censorship which is actually fake news and so on, which is even worse than classical censorship and so on. So in this sense, I think, yes, do, and that's what I like what you said, Pamela, like, do everything you can. I mean, if you're good at cooking, cook for refugees. No, I'm not joking, really, cook for refugees. If you are good at playing in a band, play in a band. If you're good at organizing, organize. If you have money, give us all the money you have. And that wasn't a joke. No. I think also, just to finish, I think one of the biggest mistakes of progressives was that they think if you go to a festival and there is a logo there or whatever, you're sold out. No. You cannot escape capitalism. There is no outside of capitalism, unfortunately. We have to use all the means possible, which means technology, computers, transport, hopefully green transport and so on, in order to fight this system where it is possible that people, the top rich, are actually waiting for the catastrophe, what Warren Buffett said recently. He's waiting for the catastrophe which is inevitable so he can get bigger shares out of the catastrophe. We have to use this system against this system without thinking that there is an escape. I will go to my island or my little bubble and I will be fine. No, there is no escape. There is this world here and now. And it is now that we have to change it. Yeah.